Hello, it's Missy. Thank you for watching. Today's video is a Halloween-inspired tutorial. I saw a picture of this on Pinterest and I thought it would be fun to recreate. As always, let me know what you think down in the comments. Subscribe, click that bell as usual, and let's get started. I'm going to be creating two Dutch braids for this hairstyle. It's similar to a French braid, but instead of crossing the hair over the middle, I'm going to be crossing each side strand under the middle strand. I'm going to start by parting the hair in a zigzag pattern across the top of my head and then down at the back of my head to divide my hair into two sections for the braids. Now I'm going to take a small section of hair from the front on the left side, close to the hairline, and divide it into three equal sections. I'm crossing the right strand under the middle, then crossing the left strand under the middle. As I braid, I'm going to add small amounts of hair from the head into each section after I cross it under the middle strand. And I want to make sure to keep the braid tight against my scalp, holding the strands close as I'm adding in more hair. So I'm just going to repeat that pattern, crossing the side strands under the middle section while also adding in new sections of hair each time. So I'm crossing one side under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under, adding it into the middle strand. Then I'm crossing the other side under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under, adding it into the middle section as well. And I'm going to repeat this pattern, working down the side of my head from the hairline down towards the nape of my neck. Once I run out of hair to bring into the braid, I'm going to stop the braid at this point and tie it off using a clear elastic band. You could braid the hair all the way down to the bottom if you'd like, or further down depending on the style that you want to end up with. Now I'm going to repeat the same steps and create another Dutch braid on the other side of my head with the rest of the hair on that side. So I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand while adding in new sections of hair from my head. So I'm picking up a section of hair near the hairline and dividing it into three equal sections. I'm crossing the side strands under the middle strand while also adding in new sections of hair from my head. And I'm going to make this braid down the side of my head from the hairline down towards the nape of my neck. So I'm crossing one side strand under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and bringing it into the middle strand as well. Then I'm crossing the other side strand under the middle strand, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under, bringing it into the braid as well. As I braid, I'm going to add small amounts of hair from the head into each section after I cross it under the middle strand. And I want to make sure to keep the braid tight against my scalp, holding the strands close as I'm adding in more hair. So I'm just going to repeat that pattern, crossing the side strands under the middle section while also adding in new sections of hair each time. Once I've brought in all of the hair on this side and the braid reaches down to the nape of my neck, I'm going to take a clear elastic band and tie off the end of the braid so I have two ponytails at the nape of my neck. Now I'm going to hide the elastics, so I'm just going to take a small section of hair from each ponytail and wrap it around the elastics, and then I'm going to use a topsy-tail tool to slide the end of the wrapped piece through the elastic band. This will hold it in place without needing to use a bobby pin, and I just got this little tool off Amazon. Now for the ribbon part of the hairstyle, I'm going to thread a ribbon through both braids just like I would if I was lacing up a shoe. I decided to use a black colored thread just for the Halloween vibe of the tutorial. You can choose any color or thickness that you'd like. You just want to make sure that the ribbon is at least two times the length of the braids. To begin lacing the ribbon in a crisscross pattern between the two braids, I'm going to take one side of the ribbon and weave it under a section of the braid at the very top, so the very first loop of the braid on one side.
Then I'm going to pull the ribbon through the hair until it reaches about midway on the ribbon. Then I'm going to cross it over to the other braid and weave it under the first section on the opposite side. Now I'm going to cross the two ends of the braids over to the opposite sides and then weave the ends through the next section of the braid. And I'm just going to repeat this crisscross pattern, working down the lengths of the braids. It helps to look in a mirror so you can see which to cross over. Sometimes I would cross the same side twice just to make sure that the pattern was going to be right once I got down to the end. But doing it this way will create an even zigzag pattern between the two braids. So I'm just working my way down, weaving the ribbon under each section of the braid after I cross it from the opposite side. So it will create an X pattern down the middle of my head between the two braids. And once I get down to the very last section, I decided to tie the ribbon together in a bow at the nape of my neck over the top of both of the ponytails. If you have a lot of extra ribbon at the bottom, you can cut this off so that the length stops either matching the hair or just at a point where you like the way that it looks. I left my pieces long just so that they were as long as the ends of my hair. You can leave the style just like this. I did decide to go back and kind of fluff up the braids. So I went back over each braid and gently pulled on the sides of the braids to kind of pull them and loosen them out so they were wider and more flat. Then I went ahead and set the style with hairspray, smoothing down the sides of the braids to kind of tame down any flyaway pieces that were sticking out from the braid so it looked a little bit smoother and cleaner.
Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you think about this hairstyle down below in the comment section. I love this. I think this would be fun to wear even if you don't dress up for Halloween but you're going somewhere or trick-or-treating. Did I already say let me know what you think? Let me know what you think. Be sure to subscribe, click the bell as always, and I will see you next time.